This is Maria. She's often called a veritable peacemaker by others. She has a long nose, a small body, a long chin, and gray-green eyes. When she laughs, her gray-green eyes sparkles, and the tip of her nose nearly meet the tip of her chin. She works as Dublin by Lamplight Laundry. Maria sets her alarm back from 7 to 6, remembering that the next day is a mass morning. The next morning comes and it's October 31st, aka Halloween. Maria has a special trip planned to go to her friend Joe's house. Spends her day at the laundry, catering to the women who work there. At 6 o'clock, she gets ready to go. She wears her best skirt, tiny dress boots, and a nice blouse. Then she heads out onto the street. On the streets, she is thankful for her old brown raincoat, as it is raining. She takes a tramp to the pillar, where she enters Down's cake shop and buys a dozen mixed pancakes for the children and a nice plum cake for Joe and his wife. She takes a tramp again, where she meets a nice elderly man. They talk of Hollow Eve and of rainy weather. Maria thinks him to be very nice. In fact, she is so distracted by him, she leaves the nice plum cake for Joe on the train. Oh no! She has arrived at Joe's house at last. The party greets her. There is Joe, his wife, his children, including his eldest son, Alfie, and a few neighborhood girls. She then gave the bag of cakes to the eldest son, Alfie, to divide. Maria says she brought something special for Joe and his wife, but soon realizes that she has left the plum cake and becomes distressed. But that is soon forgotten as the party progresses. Joe's wife plays the piano as the children dance and sing. Maria sits to talk with Joe. When she mentions Alfie during the conversation, Joe becomes angry, cursing his brother. Miss Donnelly tries to calm him, saying that it was a great shame for him to speak that way of his own brother. Again, that is all forgotten when the neighborhood girls begin to play a Halloween game. Five items are set out on the table.
Saucer.
A glass of water, a ring, a Bible, and clay. The girls take turns blindfolding themselves and reaching for an item at random to determine their future. One receives the Bible, three receives the water, and another, blushing, receives the ring. Now it is Maria's turn. She reaches out and grabs the clay. Everyone is silent, knowing the clay symbolizes death. The party soon moves along. After some more wine and laughter, Maria is asked to sing, "I dreamt that I dwelt."
I dreamt I dwelt in marble halls with vessels and serfs at my side. And of all who assembled that I was the hope and the pride. I had riches all too great to count, and a high ancestral name, but I also that you loved me still the same.
Joe begins to cry.
I dreamt I dwelt.